Hello children, in the previous lesson we learned about medieval India. In this chapter we have to learn about medieval Kerala. Let's discuss the social life in Kerala during the period. Copper plates are the important source of history of medieval Kerala between 9th and 18th century CE. We can see a Jewish copper plate in your textbook. That is the picture of Jewish copper plate. We can see a script in that plate. The script used here is Vatteluthu, an old script. This copper plate is a record of the rights sanctioned to Anjuvanam, a group of traders, by Bhaskara Devi, a medieval ruler of Kerala based at Mahodayapuram. Next, we have to check what is meant by Perumals. Kerala was a part of the ancient Tamilagam. Ancient Tamilagam ruled by Muvendas. We have discussed the ancient Tamilagam topic in the 5th class. A kingdom based at Mahodayapuram was established by 9th century CE. The rulers in the Mahodayapuram kingdom were known as Perumals. The present Kodungallur and the surrounding areas were known as Mahodayapuram in those days. So, we can see today's Kodungallur and surrounding areas are known as Mahodayapuram at that time. The Perumals were also known as Cheras and Cheramans. Some of these rulers adopted the title Kulashekara. Most regions in the present Kerala were under the rule of Perumals. We can see a map in your textbook. Identify the map and find out the regions under the ring of Perumals. List the Nadus. We can see the ring of the Perumals extended from Kolathunad in the north to Venad in the south. Let's examine the socio-economic features of this region during the reign of Perumals. What was that? Agriculture flourished in areas close to water resources. Many regions are close to water resources, so agriculture was flourished in those areas. Brahmins established their power in agriculture villages. There are many agriculture villages. The major domination or major power was vested in the hands of Brahmins. Temples developed as centers of power. The major centers of power were temples. The ownership of farm lands was vested with the Brahmins. As I already told you that Brahmins were dominated in that society, so the ownership of farm lands was vested with the Brahmins too. Aladiyas were the people who toiled in the soil. The people or the workers who work in the soil are called Aladiyas. Besides farmers, there were many other occupational groups in villages. As agriculture became widespread, large areas of land called Nadu developed. Those who established power over the Nadus came to be known as Naduvaris. The large areas of land are called Nadu. Power over the Nadus came to be known as Naduvaris. Then what is meant by Naduvari Swarupa? The reign of Perumals came to end by the 12th century. Consequently, the chieftains who were the local ruler under the Perumals began to rule their respective Nadus independently. After the Perumals, we can see that chieftains were the local rulers under the Perumals. They began to rule their respective Nadus independently. The region under the control of a chieftain was known as Swarupam. What is meant by Swarupam? The region under the control of a chieftain was known as Swarupam. After the Perumal rule, we can see the chieftain was the power of controlling or power of ruling the region. So the region under the control of a chieftain was known as Swarupam. The joint family of the chieftain was also known as Swarupam. The eldest member of the family became the ruler. The region under the control of chieftain also known as Swarupam and the joint family of the chieftain also known as Swarupam. The eldest member of the family became the ruler. There were disparities in wealth and military power among the Nadus. The chieftains fought among themselves for power. The chieftains were fight between for the power. The major Swarupams during the period were Trippapur Swarupam in Venad, Perumbadappu Swarupam in Kochi, Nediruppu Swarupam in Kozhikode, and Kola Swarupam in Chirakkal. We can see a table. From the first one, Venad, What was the name of Swarupam in Wayanad? It is Trippapur Swarupam. And let's fill that all the table corresponding the Swarupam. Next portion is trade. We can see internal and external trade made great progress in Kerala during the medieval period. Internal trade, which means trade within the state or trade within Kerala. External trade, which means trade between the state or trade outside the Kerala. Can you guess the goods that were exchanged from Kerala? Cardamom, ginger, spice, etc. Goods from other lands also reached the markets of Kerala by trade. Given below are a few of these goods: clay pots, fishing net, silk, etc. Early trade was carried out through the exchange of goods for goods. Later goods began to exchange for money. We can see barter system that was carried out the exchange of goods for goods. Later goods began to be exchanged for money. Trade goods, namely Anjuvanam, Manigramam, etc., existed during the period. Realizing the importance of trade, the Perumals extended every help to the trade groups. Tax on trade was an important source of income during the medieval period.